Let's learn IIP. Today we will learn how to convert an XML message into a CSV message. We will not be concatenating strings to arrive at the result. That method is inefficient and error prone. Instead, we will use message models in IIP to do XML to CSV conversion. MRM is the domain chosen to create the message model. I'll create an independent IIP project, which is equivalent to a message flow project in version 7. Also, I'll be creating a message set project as shown on screen. A CSV file has multiple column elements separated by comma. The row elements are separated by a new line character. Using the XML shown on screen, we will have to model such a structure. You have seen an Excel file. A CSV is very similar to what you see on an Excel. Rows and columns. Using IIP toolkit, you can create XML schema from XML file. Similarly, you can create message set from an XML file. These helper utilities within IIP reduce the effort required from the developer. Observe the name of the XML file, the XSD file, and message set file shown on screen. They're exactly same, as I have used IIP helper utility to do the heavy lifting for me. Message set, auto-generated for us, will only include XML domain entries. You will have to manually add MRM domain entries. And after that, you will have to add a physical property called text1. For your CSV attributes, such as row delimiter and column delimiter, this physical property text1 will be used. See on screen how I have set CRLF as a row delimiter. And on a child node, I have set the delimiter to comma. This becomes our column delimiter. These are the major changes. Message flow used to convert XML to CSV is simple. It contains these three components. The first one is an acquisition endpoint to HTTP. On acquisition, that is a HTTP input node, we mention mset, the message set, and specify that it should use the format XML. Domain is MRM, message format is XML. Compute node is used to change the message format from XML to text1. That's it. When IIP serializes the input message to be transmitted over the wire, the physical property or message format will be of CSV. Now drag and drop the message flow into the execution group. A bar file will be auto-generated for you, which includes the message set and the message flow. When it's successfully deployed, then let's go to SOAP UI, mention the web service endpoint, provide the input XML structure, trigger the service, and observe that a CSV file has been generated.